Okay, now let us look into another application based on recursion, which is binary search. So here we are given a sorted array of integers and a key, which is nothing but an integer number, and we need to find the index of the key in this given sorted array. So let us look into the example. So let us consider this ARR, which is sorted array containing numbers from 1 to 9 and key with value 4. So the way the binary search works is that it will compare this value of the key with the middle value at the middle index of the array. So value at the starting index of the array is 1, value at the ending index of this array ARR is 9, and value at the middle index of this array ARR is 5. So it will compare this value of the key, which is 4, with the value of the middle index of the array, which is 5. Now this 4 and 5 don't match, and so what this binary search will do is it compares the value 5 with 4. Now since the value at the middle index of the array is greater than the value of the key, and since this array is sorted, we can say that this key 4 must be present in the left half of the array. So it will perform the search in the left half of the array. Now let us say that instead of 4, the value of the key was 6. So in this case, again, value of the key doesn't match with value at the middle index of the array. But here in this case, the value of the middle index of the array is lesser than the value of the key here, which is 6. So, and since this array is sorted, we can conclude that this key must be present in the right half of the array. So we'll perform search in the right half of the array. So this is what is the logic behind the binary search. So now let us jump directly into code. How we'll code up this logic, let us see. Okay, so this is the function binary search here. It returns the integer, which is nothing but the index at which the key is present, because we are finding the index of the key. And start is nothing but the starting index of the array, and end is nothing but the ending index of the array, and key is nothing but the value or the integer number that we want to search within this array. Oh, by the way, one point that I missed. Let us say that value of the key was 5. In that case, what will happen? The value of the key and value at the middle index of the array matches with each other. And in that case, we'll stop our search immediately. Okay, so keeping all these things in mind, let us now start writing this function binary search. So first thing that we should do here is find the middle index, right? Because our entire logic is based on that middle index. So let us say that mid is the middle index, then how we'll calculate that? We'll do start plus end minus start divide by 2. So by doing this, we'll get the middle index. So here in this case, the start will be 0 because starting index of the array here is 0. Ending index will be 9 minus 1 because there are 9 elements, minus 1, which is 8. So start will be 0, end will be 8. So 0 plus 8 minus 0 by 2, which is 4. So middle index will be 4, which is correct, right? 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. 5 is at the index 4. So we compute the middle index. Then what we'll do is, once we have the middle index, we'll check for this case, right? For the case where value of the key and value at the middle index of the array are matching. So if ARR of mid is matching with or is equals to the key, then in that case we'll immediately return the mid, that is the index at which this key 5 is present. Else if that is not the case, then what we will do is we'll compare this ARR of mid we'll check whether this ARR of mid is greater than the key. If ARR of mid is greater than the key, so let us go to our previous example. So if ARR of mid, which is 5, is greater than the key, which is 4, in that case, what we have to do is we'll call the binary search on the left half of the array, right? So what we'll do is we'll pass err, we'll pass start, and we'll pass mid minus 1. So as you can see here, we are reducing the size, of our search here. So initially we were searching from start to end. Now we are searching from start to mid minus 1. So mid is here and mid minus 1 starts from, it's here. So we are searching from start to mid minus 1. So we'll pass err start mid minus 1 and key, the key that we want to search. And we'll return this result, right? We'll return the result of this search, searching in this left half of this array. So that is what we'll do when err of mid is greater than key. Else, what we'll do is we'll do binary search on the right half of the array, right? If err of mid is less than key, the else part is err of mid is less than key. If error of mid is less than key, is this case, right? Here the value of the middle value at the middle index of the array is less than the value of the key. That is, error of mid is less than key. Then we'll do binary search on the right half of the array, right? So err, then mid plus one, and then key. Okay, so and we'll return the result of this search, that is search on the right half of the array. Okay, so this forms the recursive call. So this is the recursive call one, and this is the recursive call two. So we'll either search on the left half of the array or right half of the array, and if there is a match at the first place, then we'll directly return the mid. Okay, so that's all about recursive call. Now let us look into the base case as well. So here we'll hit the base case when end is less than the start. So if we keep on doing this, right, if we keep on moving to the right half of the array or left half of the array based on the value of key being greater than or less than the value at the middle index of the array, at one point will our start and end index will overlap with each other, they'll cross each other basically. So in that case, our end will become less than the start. So initially start will always be less than the end, because the size of the array is always positive and start index will be always less than end index, less than or equal to end index. So but as we keep on moving forward in our binary search, the start index will become greater than the end index at one point, and at that point we'll return minus 1. So we return minus 1 because if end becomes less than start, then in that case we need to return minus 1, because this is the case where we weren't able to find the key in this array, and in that case we'll return minus 1. So this is the base case. In fact, this is also the base case. So this is base case 1, when end becomes less than start, we need to return minus 1. That is, we weren't able to find the key in this array error. And the second base case is when the value at the err of mid, that is value at the middle index of the array, is matching with the value of the key. In that case, we need to return the mid, that is the index at which this key is present. So okay, that's all about this binary search. So just for the sake of completion, let me return 0 here. Okay, so that's all about this binary search. So we have written the base cases here. So here is the mid computation, this is base case 1, base case 2 is here, and here are the recursive calls. So yeah, with this function binary search is over. We can call this function binary search by passing the array error, starting index as 0, ending index as size minus 1, where size is the size of the array, and key is obviously the integer value that we want to search for in this array error. Okay, so I hope you understand how this binary search work, and yeah, thanks for watching. I'll end this video here.